The American Medical Association recently recommended that the U.S. begin testing seafood for radiation. However, the U.S. currently has the highest allowable recommended levels for radiation for food in the world. This is a loophole that concerned citizens have addressed by filing a legal document known as a citizen petition to the U.S. FDA. The National Academies of Science has stated that there are no safe levels of radiation. This is the petition. Citizen petition, action requested, statement of grounds. You can go in and read this. It has been 1 year since Fukushima Fallout Awareness Network, or FAN, filed the citizen petition. It is a legal document which requires a response from the FDA. They may choose to either work towards meeting the petition goals, or they may reject it entirely. And while the FDA has responded that they need more time to consider their next response, FAN feels that 1 year is long enough. We need your help now so that the FDA understands that we are serious and require their full cooperation immediately on this critical issue. So we are in the Take Action Today tab. Easy steps to help protect our food today. Number one, donate your time and or your money to FAN's crucial effort today. Number two, sign FAN's food and safety petition. Say bye-bye Becquerels and keep harmful radioactivity out of our children's food. So let's take a look at a little bit more information about this. Down here below, the current U.S. FDA recommendation, which is not binding, is 12 times higher than the limit in Japan. Before the Fukushima nuclear disaster, Japan's now accepted limit of 100 becquerels per kilogram would have been enough radioactivity to handle the contaminated material, like nuclear waste is handled. But after Fukushima, it is considered all right to eat it, and anything above that 100 becquerels per kilogram could be placed in the markets of other countries, like the U.S., who have high cesium limits. Studies indicate that in post-Chernobyl Belarus, at just 11 becquerels per kilogram of internal cesium contamination, children can be susceptible to heart problems, and at 50 becquerels per kilogram, children can start to have permanent tissue damage. Additionally, in a 2011 report, International Physicians for the Prevention of Nuclear War, or the IPPNW of Germany, has determined that the European Union cesium limit of 370 becquerels per kilogram for babies and 600 for adults is woefully unprotective. Such high limits for cesium could be responsible, in combination with other man-made radioactivity like strontium-90, plutonium-239, and iodine-131, where cesium-137 is a sentinel indicator for the presence of these other isotopes and often does not exist without them, for roughly 150,000 additional cancer deaths in Germany alone if people consume only products contaminated to the maximum permissible limit. This number does not account for the incidence of cancer, nor any other wide-ranging diseases or genetic disorders radiation could cause. The highest limit in Europe is half of the 1,200 becquerel per kilogram of cesium that the U.S. FDA recommends as its action limit. We should note, however, that the U.S. recommendation comports very closely with the 1,250 becquerel per kilogram limit for most foodstuffs proposed by Euratom. That's the European Atomic Energy Community. That's the body of the EU that promotes nuclear power. The IPPNW report recommends a 4 becquerel per kilogram of cesium-137 and a 4 becquerel per kilogram limit of cesium-134 for children, which those limits are very similar to the 5 becquerel per kilogram we are asking the FDA to implement for everyone. Beyond nuclear beliefs, it is impractical for the U.S. to have one standard for adults and one for children. It would be difficult to regulate, and it would add to the cost of the implementation. So protection for the most vulnerable, those up to at least age 17, should be the guiding principle used to set the standard, when in fact, the IPPNW report recognizes this fact as well. Also, there's a little bit more information regarding this if we go into the media tab. And here you can find Cindy Folkers of beyondnuclear.org, who gave this 15-minute, very informative, concise presentation as part of the 2-day international symposium on the medical and ecological consequences of the Fukushima nuclear accident, which was held at the New York Academy of Medicine, New York City, in March 2013, that was co-sponsored by the Helen Caldicott Foundation and Physicians for Social Responsibility. If you have not seen this, please watch it. If you have seen it, please watch it again. Because in here, you will find everything that you need to know and understand regarding why the citizens' petition was filed to the USDA, US FDA, and why exactly that your support is so desperately needed. There are an awful lot of other links and interviews that you can find there as well. So, going back to the Take Action tab, let's take a look at FAN's food safety petition. This is considered the companion petition that will be sent to the FDA Commissioner Margaret Hamburg, the United States House of Representatives, the United States Senate, and President Barack Obama. This is very easy to sign. This is moveon.org petitions. Just fill this out, take maybe 1 minute, leave a comment, and sign the petition. This will support that we are asking that the limit be reduced to 5 becquerels per kilogram for all food, nutritional supplements, and for pharmaceuticals, or even lower when technology allows, and that we quickly and responsibly institute widespread transparent testing to ensure this limit, particularly in the wake of Japan's catastrophic and ongoing radiation releases from Fukushima Daiichi's triple nuclear meltdowns. Okay. Submit your comment to the FDA and insist that they lower the acceptable levels of radioactive contaminants currently allowed in our food supply. Here we have a tab for organizations, and here we have one for individuals. Please endorse FAN's urgent FDA food safety petition. The FDA has accepted FAN's citizen petition into their process. However, in order for them to work with us in an official capacity, we urgently need your comments now. They are accepting comments and supporting documents from individuals such as yourself, mothers, fathers, teachers, coaches, physicians, nurses, professors, scientists, the list goes on. The more concerned individuals who submit their comments in support of this urgent matter, the sooner the FDA will officially accept the petition. And by signing and commenting on the citizen petition to the FDA, You will join our list of endorsers, and your comments will be published in our ongoing campaign to educate and encourage other individuals to do the same. Here are a couple of examples. And here is the link to the FDA Submit a Comment petition. This is in regulations.gov. You have this area here. Put in your comments. There is also a checklist. It might be a little guideline for you to follow if you feel necessary. You can also upload files here and supporting evidence and documents. Please keep your comments civil and put in your first and last name here. You can also provide more contact information if you wish. And then finally, we need to use this box to categorize if we are an individual, an industry, or an academic. So most of us are going to fall under the individual category, which would be individual consumer. Click on the continue button to finish. Okay, let's see. And we can send a message to your representative to demand that the FDA do their job to protect our families by monitoring our food supply. And this sample letter is right here. Here's a sample letter you can copy, paste, and send to your elected officials. It's always good to add your own words as well, and it's easy to do. Just click on this link and find your representatives. This is very important that we understand that, you know, all children worldwide deserve equal protection. So please tell me why children in the U.S. are allowed to eat at minimum 12 times more man-made radioactive poison in their food than children in Japan. So I'm also sending this to my very local city officials because I know they don't understand this. I know they have no clue. So this is about educating as well as taking action, supporting Fukushima fallout awareness. Okay. You can also join FAN on Facebook to get up-to-date information. Radiation continues to emit from Japan's Fukushima nuclear plants, and this is affecting the global environment as well as our food supply. Education and awareness are key. Education and awareness are key. Also, you can take a look and read Silence Deafening, Fukushima Fallout, A Mother's Response. Silence Deafening, Fukushima Fallout, A Mother's Response speaks to the urgent need for the U.S. and international food monitoring due to the ongoing nuclear crisis at the Fukushima Daiichi as radioactive fallout is now migrating to our homes and our kitchens. This was written by the founder and director of Fukushima Fallout Awareness Network, or FAN. Kimberly Roberson's groundbreaking book explains in lay terms how we got here and underscores the immediate need to monitor our food and also hasten the transition to renewable energy now. On behalf of Fukushima Fallout Awareness Network, Ecological Options Network, Beyond Nuclear, and Citizens for Health, we would like to thank you for your support.